Hello everyone, in this video we have a right triangle and there is an angle bisector line here, and then this length is given 12 units and here is given 15 units. These angles is given 90 degrees and the question is, what is the sum of x and y? Okay, first step, let's call these two equal angles alpha, and here let's call theta. If you notice that alpha plus theta equal 90 degrees, that means here must be equal theta, and here must be equal alpha, right? Okay. After that, if you draw a perpendicular line like this, notice that there is an angle bisector line here. That means these two parts must be equal to each other. And also, these two parts are equal. That means here must be equal 12 units. So, 3 units left here. Let's remind you, if we have an angle bisector line like this, let's call here point K. If we draw a perpendicular line and one more, these two parts must be equal to each other. And also, these two parts are equal to each other. As a result, this triangle and this triangle are congruent. Okay, let's return the question. If it works on this triangle, let's call these equal parts M. If we apply Euclid theorem for triangle AED, M squared equal 12 times 3, so m squared equal 36, that means m equal 6 units. Let's write here, m equals 6, and then if you focus on this triangle, notice that if here is theta, that means this angle here must be equal alpha, right? Therefore, we get one more an angle bisector line. Therefore, if you focus on this triangle, according to angle bisector theorem, ratio of 6 over 3 must be equal x over y. That means x equal to y. That's right here, x equal to y. And then for this triangle, if we apply Pythagorean theorem, 6 squared plus 3 plus y whole squared equal 2y whole squared, right? Okay. Therefore, 36 plus 9 plus 6y plus y squared equal 4y squared. If you organize the equation, 3y squared minus 6y minus 45 equals 0. If you divide both sides of the equation by 3, we get y squared minus 2y minus 15 equals 0. You know that's minus 15 equals minus 5 times 3, that means y equal 5 units. That's right here, y equal 5, and x equal 10, because it's 2 times y, that means sum of the x and y must equal 15 units. In addition, if you notice that this triangle is a 6, 8, 10 spatial right triangle. Okay. So the first method, now we will calculate value of x plus y using second method. First of all, if we extend point B and point E like this, let's call here point K. If you focus on triangle KAD, this triangle has both an angle bisector and a height. That means triangle KAD is an isosceles triangle. Right? Therefore, the length of the KA must be equal to the length of the AD. So, if it is 15 units, that means this length must be equal to 15 units, so 3 units left here. We know that here is 90 degrees, and if you focus on this triangle, let's call here A. For this triangle, if we apply Euclid theorem, A squared must be equal 12 times 3, that means A equal 6 units. A equals 6, and notice that this line segment is an angle bisector, so if there's a 12 units opposite of the 6, opposite of the x here must be equal to x, right? According to angle bisector theorem. After that, if we apply Pythagorean theorem for triangle ABC, 12 squared plus 6 plus x whole squared must be equal 2x whole squared, right? Therefore, 144 plus 36 plus 12x plus x squared equal 4x squared. So 3x squared minus 12x minus 180 equals 0. Therefore, if you divide both sides of the equation by 3, we get x squared minus 4x minus 60 equals 0. We know that minus 60 equals minus 10 times 6, so x minus 10 times x plus 6 equals 0. That means x equal 10 units. Let's write here x equal 10, and notice that 2x equal 15 plus y, that means 2 times 10 must be equal 15 times y, so y must be equal 5 units. That means sum of the x and y equal 15 units. Now also we will calculate value of x plus y using third method. First of all, let's call these two equal angles alpha and here theta. That means here is also theta and this angle here is also alpha, right? If you notice that this triangle and this triangle have same angles, that means these two triangles are similar, right? Next step, let's call here M. Therefore, M, which is opposite of the 90 degrees, over 15, which is opposite of the 90 degrees, must be equal 12, which is opposite of the theta, over M, which is opposite of the theta. Therefore, M squared equal 180 So m squared equal 36 times 5. That means m equal 6 root 5 units. Okay. Let's write here m equals 6 root 5. Therefore, for this triangle, if we apply Pythagorean theorem, we find this side to be 3 root 5 units. And also, if we apply Pythagorean theorem for this triangle, this side we'll find to be 6 units. Okay. Next step, if you draw a perpendicular line like this, if you focus on this triangle, if it is alpha, that means here must be equal theta. Right? That means this triangle and this triangle are similar. If you focus on triangle ABE, the ratio of the length of this triangle is 2, right? That means for this triangle, ratio of the length must be equal to. That means if here is B, here must be equal to B. Right? Or you can think like this. For this triangle, if we calculate tangent alpha equal 1/2. Right? That means for this triangle, tangent alpha is also must be equal 1/2. Next step, for this triangle, if we apply Pythagorean theorem, b squared plus 3b whole squared equal 3 root 5 whole squared. Therefore, 5b squared equal 45, that means b squared equal 9, so b is going to be 3 units. Let's write here, b equal 3, and here is 6. If you notice that, this triangle and this triangle are similar, right? That means ratio of 3 over 12 must be equal y over whole length, y plus 15. So, if we simplify, therefore, 4y must be equal y plus 15, 3y equal 15, so y is going to be 5 units. Let's write here, y equal 5. Notice that this triangle is 3, 4, 5, spatial right triangle. That means here must be equal 4 units. So x is going to be 10 units. Therefore, sum of the x and y equal 15 units. Okay. This was the third method. Now we will calculate sum of the x and y using fourth method. First of all, let's call these two equal angles alpha and here theta. That means here is also theta and this angle is also alpha. Okay. After that, if we draw a perpendicular line like this, and let's extend here, and then if we extend corner E like this, let's call here point K. If you focus on this triangle, here must be equal theta. Right? Notice that there's an angle bisector line here, and this angle is 90 degrees. That means triangle ADK is an isosceles triangle. That means the length of the AD must be equal to the length of the DK. if this triangle is an isosceles triangle, therefore these two parts must be equal to each other. Next step, if here is theta, this angle is also theta, and notice that here is 90 degrees, and here is also alpha. This triangle and this triangle have same angles and opposite of 90 degrees have same length. That means these two triangles are congruent. Therefore, the angles opposite alpha are also equal. After that, if here is 12 units, that means this length must be equal 12 units, right? You know that this length is 15, that means 3 units left here, right? Okay. Then this triangle and this triangle are similar. So, ratio of 3 over 12 must be equal y over y plus 15. So, y is going to be 5 units. Here is 5, here is 4, and let's call these two equal parts n. Therefore, here is also n. Therefore, according to the similarity theorem, 5 over 4 must be equal 15 over 2n. Right? This side. So, if you simplify the expression, therefore, 2n equal 12, that means n equal 6. That's right here, n equal 6. Therefore, x equal 10 and y equal 5. So, sum of the x and y equal 15 units. Thanks for watching. If you want more videos like this, please don't forget to like and subscribe my channel. Take care and